today. My name's John Costa, and I edit Citizen's Eye. A lot of you probably know what we do with Citizen's Eye as TV reporters since 2009, because you didn't see me all week. Because all week we actually ran an FM radio station, which some of you probably weren't aware of, broadcasting on FM, on the internet, every day for 4 hours. So a lot of our community reporters that may have taken your photograph or interviewed you or got you to speak into a telephone, you were talking to me back at Handy Radio. So yeah, it's very fond memories for us, because we've only been going a year, it's an opportunity to do lots of stuff. It's good to see some old faces, and I don't mean old, that's old.
Thank you,
I mean that's in like old friends, I know. And I'll be joined by Councillor Ben Jr. Super Assistant Mayor, which I'm really proud of, and also Councillor Tim Cassidy, thank you very much for coming down and supporting us today. And can I take this opportunity to maybe invite yourself, Ben Jr., to say a few words?
Yeah. Okay. I'll start. Thanks, John. Thanks for organising this with Jim and volunteers. It doesn't seem 3 years away, does it, from when we had that wonderful event in Leicester, that the London Olympics has looked at what we did in Leicester and they're saying, you did it very well, so we better try well as well. So probably we'll have a very good opening ceremony on Friday night. It won't be as good as ours on that 25th of July 2009, then, will it? With Lee performing on the stage, keeping it all in order. It was a wonderful week in Leicester, and it's great to see people involved, some of the athletes, obviously the volunteers that came for that week, who made a difference in their lives. Now, I know Lee's been able to go and do some media training and since then, and I'm sure other athletes have done, and it's great to see these young volunteers still involved in this. Leicester showed the way, and Wayne, Councillor Wayne Naylor there as well. thank you very much for inviting us here today. It's always good to celebrate success, and it was success. Wonderful to see a torchbearer. I was told Billy Mitchell was coming, but he's not, is he? From EastEnders. You don't know what's going on, do you?
I'm not an EastEnders fan.
But thank you very much for all the very best.
Ambassador, he had a reception
in the United States. There are so many teams who came from other parts of the country, and they were saying, Leicester games were the best ones.
Yes.
When are you going to host a game? I said, whenever we can get some money, we would love to host that. And after the games, I met Andy Reid, who is the chief executive of Leicestershire. And he said, the opening ceremony days, and there were 22 countries, and he said, it was nothing like Leicester. He said, Leicester shows a way. So I'm really grateful to my team's game. He was ambassador, consistently in his year. And everybody came together. You name any walk of life, people were there. And these memories are captured in the legacy of Special Olympics, where the Indian justice came up. But now, you are ready the course over. And the social media is very important. I've been told there was a documentary last week, which has been to the World War. And what Special Olympics that did to our needs and the families, that is a great legacy. And I want that we have to show the world that it does
basketball, eh?
chair back.